Every soldier in the U.S. Army was issued their basic wool uniform. These were used for everything, from dress, to garrison, to even combat. For the vast majority of GI impressions regarding the ETO and the MTO, the wool uniform will be what you want to wear.
The uniform pattern was adopted in the mid-1930s during a time when the United States military was changing. New equipment, firearms, and of course uniforms. Contrary to the form-fitting uniform of the First World War, this uniform was a much looser fit, leaving much more room for mobility.
The wool uniform was designed out of serge wool in the shade OD33, initially featuring a structured collar.
By 1941 to 1942, they started making changes to the basic wool uniform in order to make it easier to produce, but also to make them more useful against gas attacks. They added a gas flap to the trouser fly and to the shirt, as well as a convertible collar rather than the structured collar. Both the World War I and World War II basic uniform were made mainly from wool materials. This was due to the fact that wool was durable, easily dyed various colors, quick drying, breathable, and easily recyclable. Wool textiles were also natural. Due to this nature, should the wool be burnt while being worn, it would not stick to the soldier's skin.
A belt is, of course, needed to keep your trousers up on your body as best as it can. These belts were to be cut down to your waist size and fitted to you appropriately, also going through the same phases as other webbing went through during the war, starting off in OD3 and then eventually transitioning to the OD7 shading. Now, after a little bit of history, we can move on to where to buy them. Luckily for many of you, original GI wool uniforms are still in very available supply. Such sites like eBay as well as surplus and antique stores have a fairly strong chance of having these uniforms available, as well as vendors at reenactments, where your chances are arguably better. However, for those having a hard time finding their size, or would just simply prefer not to wear an original uniform, reproductions are in extremely available supply. The vast majority of World War II GI websites offer the wool uniform in less than common sizes. However, out of all the reproduction websites, the most well-known are these three.
While there are other companies manufacturing wool uniforms, these three in particular come to mind when thinking of the favorites of the reenacting community. In terms of pricing, these will be ranked from least expensive to most expensive, so take the pros and cons of each company's uniform into consideration before making your purchase. What Price Glory's wools are some of the most affordable. Their shirts and trousers are advertised as 100% wool, and they offer their shirts in both the structured collar and convertible collar form. However, keep in mind that the material is not as thick as other companies listed here.
It is also important to know that both their trousers and shirts are produced overseas. At the Front offers a more basic selection. Their wool trousers and shirts are advertised as a wool polyester blend. However, they do offer an economy shirt made out of cotton flannel. In terms of shirts, they only produce the structured collar. On the other hand, their wool is thicker in comparison to What Price Glory's. This results in their price being more on the moderate part of the spectrum. Their wools come in at this price because they are also imported. While at the highest price point, World War II Impressions is known for being high quality, comfortable, breathable, 100% wool, and made in the USA. World War II Impressions is also known for using some of the most authentic materials and pattern designs when it comes to the production of their products. Unfortunately, they fall at the highest price point. Considering most of us who reenact will be wearing these wools in the cold, wet, and mud, it's best to explore other options before committing to this more expensive set of wools. When considering where to buy your trouser belt, all three of these companies offer a belt at a very similar price point. The most recent run of the At the Front trouser belt would be the most affordable and quality option for a good belt. It is important to understand, when purchasing these uniforms, it is imperative that you conduct thorough research on the uniform that you are buying. Read reviews and analyze the specific company's sizing charts and fit specifications. This is to ensure that you will be receiving a uniform that will not only last you a long time, but will also be able to be worn even if you gain or lose weight. The ages of 17 to 18 is when you normally first start getting into the hobby. You are still growing, so take this into consideration when making these online purchases. When entering into this hobby, it is vital that you start off with a good, solid foundation for your impression to be built upon. Consider your basic wool uniform that foundation.
Putting in the time, effort, and research from the start will always benefit you in the end. With all that being said, we hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to stay tuned for our future episodes.
And remember,
you're in the army now, you're not behind the plow. You'll never get rich by digging a ditch, you're in the army now. You're in the army now, you're in the army now. You'll never get rich on the salary which you get in the army now.